listening to Radio Luxembourg and catching a Beatles tune off of there could have consequences for their job, for their education. Trying to buy a Beatles album somewhere on the black market could have led to arrest. Attending a concert where Beatles songs were being sung could have consequences for people in that society that we can't even imagine. And I think when you live in a situation like that, you end up developing, I think, a much more intense relationship with the music.
We'd known that with the Beatles, it was just impossible to go and play there. Our records weren't on sale there. You know, if you want a guaranteed way to make people popular, that's it. Deny them it.
They were not on sale in Russia. There were some songs, small LPs with a couple of songs only.
This is the first Paul McCartney LP published in Russia officially. You see the logo, Ministry of Culture of the USSR. Band of Duran was dropped from this album because the reference to prison, the band, Duran, it's bad for the ordinary Soviet listener to have this record.
I could fulfill one of my wishes in life only back in 1984 when I bought all the Beatles LP records.
When you were young and your heart was an open book, you used to say, live and let live. You know you did, you know you did, you know you did. If this ever-changing world to live and let die.
In the 60s and the 70s, there's been all kinds of very funny and strange ways to get the Beatles music into the Soviet Union. Lots of albums have been smuggled into the country. At the black market, they costed a lot. Average monthly wage in the Soviet Union at that time was 150 rubles a month, and one new Western long-playing album costed from 50 to 80 rubles. So this was one half of an average monthly wage. Still, kids bought these albums and cherished them, and you know, they were really like religious objects.
We didn't know much about things happening in the outer world. We didn't have music because it wasn't on stock. We didn't have records. We didn't have even tape recorders. It was never on the radio.
Someone in the Komsomolskaya Pravda had written an article in the newspaper talking about how you could take the normal parts from a telephone, hook them up to an acoustic guitar, and create an electric guitar. And almost overnight, every public phone in Moscow had been plundered. What they found early on was that the emulsion on X-ray plates were able to carry sound. And so there was a whole business in taking discarded X-ray plates from hospitals.
They were called пластинки на костях, discs on the bones. And you literally could see, you know, broken bones, skeletons, and so on. And then you put on this flexi disc and you can listen to rock and roll music.
Someone's knocking at
Maybe for us, the Beatles were more than the Beatles for any other country, because in any other country, people could feel that they're not far from them. One day they come to their town, they play the show, you can go to the shop and buy a new record. We understood that we live on a separate planet and they will never come here, never will see the albums in the shop. That's why it was much more important for us.
We have to be alone on a hill. The man with the foolish grin is keeping perfectly still. But nobody wants to know him. They can see that he's just a fool, and he never gives an answer. But the fool on the hill sees the sun going down, and the eyes in his head see the
out over all the Red Square buildings, all this great sort of Russian scenery that I'd only ever seen in films before. And it just occurred to me that I was thinking, the fool on the hill sees the sun going down. And I looked up and it was me looking over Red Square, and the sun was just going right down over that building. And the eyes in his head, and it's like, it's just me. I'm going, ah, this is happening. It's magical.